Most believe that the greatest trick a magician can do.
What is going on?
No!
Is to convince the world that the impossible is real.
Amazing.
But when the magic is real,
no one is in on it.
How does she do that?
Yet seems impossible.
That's real.
That's the greatest trick of all. Magic, the most important thing to a magician is his hands. You know, everything that you do is based on being able to manipulate and control, right? So this type of stuff, it looks simple, but it's actually me working for a long time to figure out how to do this stuff. And it's practice. It's hours and hours and hours of practice. So the one thing that a magician, I think, values more than anything else is just the hands. There's a trick in magic, right, where the magician puts some sort of a stake under a bag or a cup like this. And kind of the magician doesn't know where the stake is. So what happens is a random selection is made and the magician slams his hand down over one of the three objects. And usually the magician is fine. The three of us will stand over there and we'll all look this way. And please, nobody give them a signal, because we're leaving this up to them. And you guys are gonna decide which bag you put the ice pick under. You're gonna be the one picking the cup. So the fate of my hands lies in your decisions.
Have you seen him do this before?
No.
No,
this is brand new.
That's why I had to scurry over here. I don't see this.
It'll be good.
If he fails, I'm gonna leave extremely shortly after. I'm not sticking around.
Can you point to one of the four cups?
How much is writing on this? On this?
Everything.
Everything.
Point to one of the bags. Point to one of the bags. This one?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That one? Point to one fast, point fast. I saw your reaction. See, both bags moved, but one didn't move the same way, which means technically that I know it's here. But the truth is, maybe it doesn't matter one way or another. Like, ultimately, when we watch magic, the problem with this trick is you don't want this to really succeed, because
no, of course
the real
not.
Curiosity is what would happen if that went through the hand. This is my right hand. This is a hand that I use to do everything. This is an ice pick. This hasn't been switched in or out. This has been here the whole time. Is that true?
Yeah.
Do you want to make sure it's actually what it seems to be?
Oh. No, Ross, I can't. I'm like checking on myself. Yeah, that's definitely what it seems to be.
This is complete mind over body. How it really looks, like it's going through the hand?
Yeah.
And does it really look like it's actually?
It is, yeah. Oh, really? God, no. Oh,
it looks like
wow.
It's actually going in, but there's no blood. See, this is ultimately what they want to see, Kanye. See that? Look, ultimately in magic, that's what people care about. It's that. See? You see, that's really what they want to see.
Oh, my God.
Wow. 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 You can see the pressure.
Because then he'll clap by accident.
That is through your hand.
But there's no blood.
Why?
And this is the part that could be messy, by the way. Do you want to just feel it? Make sure it's actually not an illusion, honey.
Man, I lost my erection entirely.
Pull it like this?
Pull it straight out. Good. Grab it and just pull it right out. Good. Good. Just pull that guy. Just pull.
Oh!
Pull.
Oh!
Pull. Good. Pull. Ah! You wanna hold my wrist?
Ninja skills.
Just hold me steady. Pull. Go ahead, pull. 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 Done. Nothing.
Oh!
No man. Blood. Nothing, like I promised.
It went through your hand. It feels like it went through your hand. This is not a glove.
That doesn't retract. Oh my God. Man, I was having a pretty trap day.
Wow. Wow. That's the craziest thing I've ever seen in my entire life, obviously. I can't even. You're out of your mind in the most, you're just out of your mind in the most beautiful way possible.
That is
my
amazing.
God.
I'm really freaked out.
It's just so gross.
No, okay.
Open here, you open here, and just see when I squeeze. You see how your fingers want to close with them? You feel that? Feel how you really...
Yes.
This is all happening in their minds. It's not about the trick at all.
See how his want to close?
Call it power of suggestion. Call it involuntary reflex. Regardless, one thing is true. We all want to feel connected to others. That idea is more powerful than any magic I could do. I'm gonna try to sync the two of you with each other. I'm gonna try to sync the two of you together. So you'll be connected just through very simple psychological control.
Yes, Jesus, that would be fantastic.
Yeah. I'm about to say that.
Close your eyes. Good. Her eyes are closed. She can hear my voice, but she can't see anything that I'm doing. Open your eyes for the first time. Tell us exactly what you felt. Tell us exactly what you felt. Say it.
I just got full of emotion.
Uh-huh. And did you feel a touch?
I did.
Where did you feel the touch?
On my shoulder.
Which shoulder? Which shoulder?
My right.
Tell her what happened.
While your eyes were closed, he touched my right shoulder. When you said it just now, you moved your right shoulder. He just put his finger here and pushed down on my right shoulder.
And your body moved accordingly. And you weren't watching, your eyes were closed.
Yes.
And you really felt something for real. It wasn't just a...
You didn't touch me.
They were...
No.
Somebody touched my shoulder. David?
He touched my shoulder while your eyes were closed. Yeah.
No.
Mom, nobody touched you.
Okay, now I'm about to cry.
Yeah.
Are you serious? Somebody touched my shoulder.
No, he touched my shoulder.
God. Okay.
Okay.
Close your eyes. Pay attention to everything. Open your eyes. I just saw you do a little, I saw a little something, like a little reaction, which is okay.
Okay.
Tell us exactly what you felt. Tell us.
You, like, pushed me on the shoulder.
But I want to say one thing. It's possible that you think that when your eyes were closed that we all set this up on you in that one moment because your eyes were closed and I could have said to everybody, pretend. Well, we're gonna try it in reverse this time.
Okay.
I'm gonna see if you can connect with your dad in the opposite direction. Close your eyes. Open your eyes. Did you feel anything?
Yeah.
What did you feel?
What? You talk now. Yeah.
Of any color you're thinking of it.
Same.
So when I say think of any color, say it in your head over and over.
I got it.
Maybe come right here.
Right here.
Yeah, also perfect.
You're both so in on this. I don't believe you.
I
do.
Stay here.
Bull.
Yeah, yeah. But listen to me. Here's a part that's important. Even if they're in on it, nobody knows what color you're thinking of, okay? You want me to make it appear right across the wall, your color. Okay, I'm gonna make it appear right over love.
We were promised fire as well. I hope you
okay, you,
deliver.
You want fire?
I want fire.
I need alcohol for that. Somebody has a drink with them, right?
I do.
And I need something to light on fire. Does somebody have? Perfect. Let me dip this right in here.
Perfect.
Okay. You're thinking of a color.
Yes.
And I said that we're gonna make it appear right here for you.
Okay.
Okay? I won't flinch from that. Your color will appear right where you want it to. Do you want to tell everybody what your color is?
No, I want you to tell me. Love me.
Indigo.
What? That's my color! What are you doing?
Holy
shit. Wait, what, where's the color?
There!
Y-N-D-G-O-Y-O.
Do you have a bill, like a big bill on you?
$20?
Yes, perfect. $20 bill?
Yes.
Perfect. Now, can you give her the cigarette? Here's what I want you to do.
Mm-hmm.
You see the bill?
Mm-hmm.
Can you burn a hole in the bill?
Yeah.
Yeah, burn a hole. Push it right through. Slowly, slow. Push, good, push. Yeah, slow. So it burns through. See how it burns through? Good. And let go of the cigarette. Can you see how it's through the bill? Yeah? It's okay?
Mm-hmm.
See?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do me a favor.
Uh-huh.
You grab the cigarette from the bottom, under here. Carefully, don't hurt yourself. And just see how there's a hole? Just pull. Pull. See how it goes?
What?
Take, check. Look. Make sure. It's real. Biggest you have is
the biggest
good.
One I have.
Great. A 20?
Yeah.
Can you do me a favor? Let's use that surface. Can you sign it? Here, I'll just put it here. Good, and just give it in.
I have a Sharpie.
Perfect.
For autographs?
You can think of that green. When did that start?
You see the signature? I can't copy that, correct?
No.
No,
is that
I
fair?
Could.
No.
Okay, yeah. Let me.
Who'd want to?
So this is your bill that you signed,
yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Do me a favor, can you just pinch your fingers like this for me? Yeah, good, and hold that. See, if I give the bill a little bend.
Yeah.
Right? Here, and it doesn't ruin the value. Well, I guess if you go through both serial numbers, it kind of decreases the value. But is that really ripped? Will you pull the rest off? Pull it off, yeah.
Me?
Yeah, pull it, yeah, just rip
pull
it off. Good, yeah. Good, perfect. And can you put that in my mouth, that little piece?
This guy, yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's like a reverse bris.
All right.
Okay. All right.
Shuffle half of the deck face up into face down.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see them get shuffled face up into face down.
Mm-hmm.
See that?
Yes.
You can see that they're really, you can see?
Yeah.
Okay, so. Can you can all see how they're shuffled face up into face down for real?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, do me a favor. Hold your hand like this. I'm gonna make you into the magician. Maybe the other hand is good. Yeah. Hold that for me. Good. Perfect. Okay. Where's your camera?
My camera's in my phone.
Can I take the phone out?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Perfect. And stand right here for me. I'm gonna get a picture of you. Good. Oh, that's good. It's all good. Now let me do this. I'm gonna take a picture of you
mm-hmm.
with here, holding the deck. Good. Can I give you that?
Yeah.
Good. And just, we'll close the deck up so you can see. When you look at all the cards, some are face up, face down. Yeah. Some are face down, face up. Correct?
Yes.
Think of any card. Mm-hmm. That's your phone that we just took the picture with, correct?
Yes.
Say your card out loud, number and suit.
Three of spades.
Three of spades? Mm-hmm. That's the card you want. You don't want to change your mind. You want the three of spades.
Yes.
So if you're not sure, you can change.
No, I'm very sure.
Hand him the phone for a second. I want you to come see this as well. Can you press the last picture, but not yet?
Okay.
When you open the picture, the whole deck will go back to normal. Everything will fix itself except for one card, which is a card that you just thought of. Open the picture and look very close.
Let me see.
Turn it sideways so you can see. And look, everything.
Yeah. Hold on, I'm gonna show everybody.
Oh my god!
All I had, which was the three of spades. Honestly.
And you could have changed to any card.
I'm trying to think how
that's
physically possible.
There's no way for him to know you're gonna pick the three of spades and take a picture of you while you were asleep.
Drink of it, just to... And that's a real glass, for sure.
Yeah. You should really see someone about that. You guys are missing this. He's eating my glass. The boyfriend I always wanted. Yeah, that might be blood, but I don't know if you actually bleed like the rest of us. Okay, let's not do that anymore. I'm scared now.
You want me to make a rabbit appear out of your purse?
Preferably rabbit, bunny, Shetland pony.
Oh, there is literally nothing in it. Well, actually.
That wasn't in my purse. Oh my god. Finally, you got a big laugh out of me. Is it got teeth?
Think of somebody important in your life that I could never know, somebody you're close to, okay?
Okay.
Just touch a card. It's not relevant to the anything, but just touch one. Okay, is that the card you like?
Yep.
Ace of Hearts, can I give you... Hold this for a second. No, we don't need the rest of the cards, okay? I'm gonna write your best friend's name down. Emmy. It's E-M-M-Y. And your last name... How do I spell your last name?
R-O-S-S-U-M.
Mm-hmm. Okay, perfect. So, that's right?
That's right.
That's right?
That's correct.
You're thinking of somebody important in your life?
Yeah.
Come closer, because you probably know who her friends are. Look what I do. If I take this lighter, watch close. I just heat it.
Ridiculous. That was crazy. That was crazy. And not just Matt, Maddie.
Oh my God.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Let me ask you a question. Does anybody know how to shuffle, like, actually, like that? You do? Like,
yeah, David, I can shuffle.
Do me a favor, shuffle these. I want to try something. I'll let you.
They are shuffled.
There's a black card here and a red card here. You shuffle three times.
I did.
You're gonna deal them face down one at a time in any order that you want. Face down one at a time, any way that you want. No, but on top, like that. Yeah, yeah, so I can't. It doesn't have to be even. You can do three in it, whatever you want. Mm-hmm. Here, keep them in. Keep them neat so I can't
see. That's my job in our relationship.
Yeah, I'm not very neat.
Yeah. You see the way she opens up the chips.
Yeah, it's a disaster.
It'll drive you crazy. Honeycombs?
Oof. Everywhere.
Rips it up. Don't
stay
fresh. You
know what? You want to mix them in your hands a little bit? Let's just push them in, whatever, just so you don't know. Good, and keep going. I don't care. And remember, there's two black cards out, so okay, I think you did it fine. So look, make sure I don't do sleight of hand. Here's where you felt the black cards went, correct?
Yes.
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
So this was your guess. You dealt into this pile, yes? After he shuffled.
Yes.
Right? You see that?
Yes.
And let me just say, here's where you thought the reds were good, so the blacks are, it means that the balance is right. But here's what's interesting. You actually got every single black card exactly as you were supposed to, even though he shuffled and you dealt. You actually
Stop.
Got, look, every single
Stop.
Black card in the deck. Yeah, yeah, well, because you knew. You dealt. You kind of knew.
What?
But look, hold on, let's show these, because just to see, and we don't need to spend. That's a red pile, let me just break it here. You got a perfect.
Come on, man. Perfect.
What?
Red and black divide.
What?
Liv.
Wow.
Hey.
Welcome.
Think of any card in the deck. Great. Hold the deck. You're thinking of a card? Do I know what card you're thinking of? Your card just left the deck. Just now. Look through the deck. Your card isn't there. Go ahead. Look. Yeah. It's not there. You won't see it there. No. It's nowhere. Here's what we'll do. Harrison, do me a favor. Grab a piece of fruit for me, like a one that we can open up. Yeah, grab a piece of fruit. Good, whatever. And can we cut this? Can we take a knife and put it right there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can put it right here. Say your card out loud.
Nine of hearts.
Nine of hearts.
Yeah.
Can you turn this sideways? Yeah, so I can cut right through it. Let me not hit your hand. Let's do. Hold. Yeah. See inside. See how there's a card in the orange?
No way.
See how there's one card inside? Please remove it. Take it out. Go ahead, pull it out. Open it up, Harrison.
No, that's just crazy.
Get the out of my house. Okay. Whoa.
No.
Yeah, it's that move.
Oh. You want an Alka-Seltzer?
I don't, and that's not, that's real.
There's a very fine line between a magician and a con artist. Can you unlock the phone?
What's his code? Tell me what his code. What's his code? What's his code?
0557.
Oh my god!
How did you know my code?
Is that the code?
That is my code! I can't stop sweating. How did you know the code?
We're on 112th Street in Madison.
We're in projects, man. That's what we got, man. It's an Afghanistan film. My boy David Flynn is there.
And, we were gonna shoot magic.
No one knows. No one knows. This is not
but us. Nobody's out because it's so cold. So they came out because they saw us through the window. So they're bringing us. I asked them if we could go inside and shoot with them, so nobody knows that we're coming.
So it was the first time. Right?
You know that game is called Three Card Monty? Usually you bet money, and if you can spot the ace or the queen, you win. This is a money card. This is all you have to do is find this, and you get whatever you got here doubled. You understand? So all you have to do is find this, but it's not going to be with two cards. I'm going to use three cards. So I got the Joker, right? And I'm going to pull out another Joker. Can you all see that? You can all see that, right? There's one Joker, there's two Jokers, and here's the money card, the one that we're playing with, right? Okay, so I do like this, right? So now you know what to follow. Okay, so I do this. Where's the queen?
Right here.
No, you just
got it.
Hold on. Let's do it again. Watch. Hold your hand out. Watch. Here, let's do it again. Because here's the idea. Ready? See? I do like this, right? Okay? And now you know this time, you know exactly where's the queen now?
Right there.
No. See, you just lost double your money.
No, I'm out of here.
Hold on. Let's do it again. So it's one, two, three. Yeah?
Yeah.
Right.
Hold your hand palm up. Now, look, here's a move really slow. I do that. I switch like this.
Two jokers.
Right.
And an ace.
No.
It's the ace here because you have two jokers.
No.
Hold on.
Whatever you think isn't what's happening, because look, lower both hands. I want you to see the ace is wherever I want it to be, even to the point that if I want the ace to be here and here.
No.
Yeah, it's that move.
Oh!
Let's hold your hands. Hold your hands up. Look close. Watch. Look, it's simple. If I do this, I do this.
There's now three aces.
Obviously, you know where the jokers were kept the whole time.
Of course I do. They're all in your pocket the entire time.
There's no way to ever win the game. Everybody's got perfect control.
No, you're killing me.
Let's go, guys.
Examine the deck. It's brand new. Because you just looked at the entire deck, subconsciously it exists in your memory. Now, you don't have access to that part of the brain. That's a photographic memory, but even that isn't actually as it sounds. Turn them face down and hold on to them so you can't see them good. And Katie, just think of any single card in the deck, any card that you want. Say it out loud.
Say it out loud?
Yeah.
Eight of hearts.
Okay, and there's no way I could have known that, correct?
No.
Do me a favor, Katie, pick up about like a quarter of the deck. About whatever you estimate.
There?
Yeah, whatever you think. You thought of any card, correct?
Yes.
And you just cut wherever you wanted to,
yes.
Correct? Did I make you do anything?
No.
Let me see where you cut.
Do people ever cry sometimes? Because it's so strange.
Give me a dollar bill. Whose $1 bill was that?
It's yours.
It was yours, and you want it to become 100.
Yeah.
If it becomes 100, you're sharing it among the four of you, right?
25, 25, 25.
Squeeze.
25.
You want 25. The print, you want it to change to a real 100.
I'm mama's, I do. About to happen.
Did it?
Amen!
Open it.
Was it 100 or $1?
I don't even know. I just did something.
We're going to x-ray this and see if this really goes through his hand.
This is the one where you fall.
And then what do? I dial 911 and I have to explain it to him.
When I was a kid, I saw a magician put a knife through his hand, and there was a lot of fake blood. It took me 10 years to figure out how to do it for real, with no blood.
You know, this is used for ice. Where are the lethal mechanisms? You're putting it through this area over here?
Yeah, it's like all different places it comes out.
All right, so how do you know to avoid the nerves, the blood vessels, the bones, the ligaments?
I brushed the nerve the other day and my hand was frozen for like 3 days.
You can see how complex and how dangerous to take an object and put it through your hand is. And especially where David's doing it, there's a whole complex of arteries there. David, as far as I know, does not have X-ray vision. So he can't know where the arteries and nerves are flowing in his hand. He is doing this, as we say, blind. No one believes this. No one. I don't know what the trick is here, but we're going to X-ray this and see if this really goes through his hand. For the record, I advised against it. Just want to let you know. There is a simple explanation, by the way. You want to know what the explanation is? David has no blood running through his veins. That's the explanation.
Hey, look, can you hold your hand out? Count 10 cards into her hand for me.
One,
two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Now, for this, we don't care what the number and suit is. We don't care about anything other than the actual paper that makes the card. You understand? Okay. You hold the big portion. I want you to do a count so they can all see it. That's one. Make sure it's not too stuck, right? That's one. Then you put it upside down on the bottom. That's a second card, right? Two. Keep going out loud.
Three.
Right?
Four.
Good.
Five.
Yep.
Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten.
Hold them against your heart for me. Do me a favor, think of a small number.
Okay, got it.
Say it out loud.
Three.
You want three cards to travel right there from here? You have 10, you want three, right?
Yes.
Have you been holding the whole time?
Yes.
Did you think of three?
Yep.
Three cards just jumped into your half. Hold your hand out. So you hold your hand out.
So you should have 13 cards.
13 cards. Count the first 10 and then show the last three.
One,
out loud.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10.
Show them. Show them.
One,
show them.
A whole, yeah. Two.
Nah. You ain't on this.
Take all of them against your heart. All of them against your heart. Hold them against your heart. Think of a number up to 10.
All right, I got it.
Say it out loud.
Nine.
Yeah. You're gonna feel it just got bigger.
Okay. Now, count again?
Count, go ahead.
One, two, three, four, five,
six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12,
13, okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Oh wait, we're short two.
Yeah.
Reach in your pocket. Go ahead, reach inside.
Yo, you pulled two cards out your back pocket.
There's
a card. Wow.
And then the other one.
That's insane.
No. Come on, man.
How'd you get the two in it? You working with him
right
now.
I swear to God.
I live right over there.
This is the one.
I get the two in the back pocket.
I'm about to hit those bars, man. I'm about to work out.
Think of any card in the deck. Good. Okay. I don't know what you're thinking. Is that fair?
That's fair.
Okay, good. Let's use the Sharpie. Can you see the logo?
Mm-hmm.
Rub it for me. Good. And you know what? Also check this side. Rub both sides. Good. And hold your fingers like this. Here's what I want you to do. Like this. Good. Great. Just squeeze it. Squeeze it. And think of your card. Okay? I don't know what you're thinking, right?
Mm-hmm.
Start rubbing the logo. Rub it with your thumb and say your card out loud.
Five of Hearts.
Okay, as you rub it, look what's happening to the logo. See how it's changing?
I did not just say that.
You see?
Oh my
God. You see what it says? Touch one. The Jack of Spades?
Yes.
Yes? You guys all see Jack of Spades? Okay, so here's what we do. The rest, can you hold this? Let's do this. We'll do a little rip. You see?
Right.
Hold this. Make sure it doesn't go anywhere. Look.
Now, if you fix that car, then I'm gonna just scream.
Well, before we fix it, we need to find a piece for it. Do you have something personal of yours, like even a wallet or a case, just something? Can you pull it out and bring it here for a second? Did I go near your wallet?
No. Oh.
See if it fits.
What?
Here, put the piece in my mouth.
Yeah.
Watch. See how?
Basic effects. Finding a card, I mean, it's been selected. Well, that's an effect.
You thought of a card.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Can you say it out loud for the first time?
Spade five.
Five of spades?
Yeah.
Where do you want it to be in the deck? Middle, bottom, top, second, you decide.
Top, here.
Top?
Yeah.
Look. The card's not in the deck. It just traveled through the air, Sai, and it landed under your watch. Look under your watch, turn your wrist over. Landed under his watch. Under his watch.
Well, it doesn't matter whether you find it under an ashtray or up behind a picture on the wall or in somebody's shoe. It's still the effect of finding an unknown card. Although there are thousands of tricks, there are only what you might call 20 basic effects. Well, of course, that's the way you take 8 notes in an octave on a piano. I mean, the number of variations they get is fantastic.
Growing up, I took cards with me everywhere that I would go. I never dreamed that those 52 cards would take me all over the world.
Let them see it. Don't let me see it. Right. Everybody else see it. You don't see it?
Yeah, they see it.
Yeah.
Oh, they see.
Here.
And they can't believe
you put it in the deck.
That this is the
no,
one.
You take the deck inside of it.
All right.
Good. Perfect.
This is the one where you fall. This is the one where you fall.
Don't I mess up?
This is the one. This is the one.
Put your card in the deck?
Oh, I put it in the deck. And I don't think there's
one more try.
All right.
Wait, we're gonna get this.
All right. Is this just a chance to throw cards at my balls?
I got it. Did you feel what I just did?
No, please tell me you didn't put it in my pocket. Don't do that. This pocket?
Deeper.
Son of, I mean, it's just not right. It's just not right. It's not right. It's not right.
Sometimes the cards are used for misdirection. Watch close.
Here's the move, and I'm going to teach it to you as I do it. See how I switch just like that? See how I do that switch? Yeah. Hold it tight so I can't. Good, like that. Now I have the club. Hold on. Without looking, what would you bet on? If you were to guess without looking, would you bet the club was on the top or bottom?
The club was on the top.
Would you be impressed if the club was on bottom, spade was on top? Because you're holding tight the whole time.
Yeah. That would be very impressive.
See, but with those guys, they couldn't even remember where the club or spade was, so I had to come up with a new way to get them.
Yeah.
That's why I came up with this. Just turn it.
Let's see.
Wow. Here, hold this one here, this one here. Hold tight, tight, tight. Tight. Say a number from one. Well, think of a number from 1 to 20.
Yeah, got it.
17? Here, I got a present for you.
Was it 17?
Right, it was 17.
Yeah, yeah. But I have a present for Mr. President. It's a.
Oh, God. I took my watch off.
I was excited to travel to England to perform for Professor Stephen Hawking, one of the world's greatest scientists.
Hawking, it's an honor to meet you. Thank you.
Hello. How are you?
He has suffered from a degenerative disease since the age of 21, and even simple communication takes enormous effort. His staff also told me he hadn't been feeling well and wouldn't be responsive.
So, Stephen, name any card that you want out loud. Any single card, and I obviously did not influence you and don't know what you're gonna say.
Nine of diamonds.
You said the nine of diamonds, and I didn't influence you at all. That's fair. You could have thought of any card, and I put this deck of cards in front of you before we began. I don't even want to touch this because I don't want you to think that I'm cheating, Stephen. But can you open up this box that I put here before it began, but keep it in everybody's sight and let Stephen see it. Open the box. And one card is at the face of the deck. Turn the deck over and let Stephen and everybody see what card is and show them as well. And Stephen, you could have thought of any single card in the deck. It's 52 different choices.
Amazing. I don't know how you did it.
Take you. I've been obsessed with this clip since I was a kid. This is Haji Ali, and he's putting a deadly amount of water into his stomach. Next, he drinks a bottle of kerosene that floats on top of the water. Then he brings the kerosene back up, creating enormous flames. Finally, he extinguishes the fire with the remaining water. Within a few short years, this act killed him, and he took his secrets to the grave. I spent over 20 years trying to figure this out. Then a video leaked online of a man water spouting with more power than I'd ever imagined. In the video, there were numbers on a wall. Through that, we were able to find his location. Finding him wasn't simple. We put ads on the radio and the newspaper and posted flyers in all the marketplaces. Finally, after 3 years, someone recognized him from the flyer. So I immediately traveled to Africa to meet him. His name is Winston Carter, and he's a 35-year-old security guard. I showed him the footage of Haji Ali's act, and I told him about my journey to learn the spout. He was shocked because he didn't know anybody else in the world could actually do this. For him, the spout has nothing to do with entertainment. Because clean water was so scarce when he was a kid, Winston learned to control the muscles around his stomach. That skill allowed him to store clean water that he could access at any point for any reason. No one inspired him to learn this feat. He generated it purely out of his imagination.
The force is from here.
He shared a secret with me. And for the first time in my life, I did it. Sort of. Back in New York, I was making progress. So I wanted to perform for one of my heroes. Woody Allen is a germaphobe and a hypochondriac.
I'm going to modestly avert my eyes and actually consume a little of that.
So to heighten the experience for him, I decided to add fish to the equation.
It's one down. Yeah, the fish are in your stomach. I got it.
I spent hours and hours spouting nothing but water. I was worried that the fish might never come out.
I can't take you any place.
Fortunately for everyone, you're they out. Finally did.
Oh.
And they're alive and well. Look, look.
I just made this malted. I would, if I were you, I would drink it. Kill the taste of the fish.
Whoa.
Yeah, don't spit it back.
It's awesome.
What can I say? Some people have it and some people don't.
My next idea was to combine it with street magic. Think of somebody important in your life. You threw the quarter right there. Mm-hmm. The name will appear right there. See how it's starting to rain? The water will make it appear. I'll help. Spout was getting stronger, I was ready to try kerosene. Every expert I consulted told me that I absolutely should not do this.
If you get any of that oil into your lungs, it'll cause a pneumonitis, which is an inflammation in the lung, which can cause severe damage. There's a chance that you could inhale some of this and you could die.
I've done extreme things with my body. I've held my breath for over 20 minutes. I've been frozen in a block of ice. And I've even fasted for 44 days. All of these were tests of endurance with unknown outcomes. But there's hard evidence that ingesting kerosene will lead to death. To force myself to go through with it, I asked Robert De Niro if I could attempt it at the opening of his Nobu Hotel.
How you doing, Bob?
Thank you so much for doing this. As simple as it looks, this was one of the scariest moments of my life. My stomach felt like it was on fire. Kerosene was dripping from my nose. I could hardly breathe. But I considered my first attempt a success because I made it through.
This is awesome.
And this amazing feat that I once thought to be impossible was finally a reality.
It's one of the best illusions I've ever seen close up. Or you're a maniac.
Look, watch this.
What?
Lick it.
Yeah.
know, it's a game that you could do as a magician.
How did you make it
here,
spin?
Watch again. Look. No, no, look again.
Go on.
I would lick it a little bit.
Yeah, do
try
that.
To lick it evenly.
Okay.
You fill up your lungs. Really,
yeah,
you really
with 20 minutes worth of cool air. Right, okay.
Oh, that's ridiculous. No, 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 no. What happened there? Seriously?
I guess it hit the current. It stuck. It was pretty good.
F*** off.
He obviously wasn't falling for it. I figured that the only way to get to him would be to do something that would make him physically uncomfortable.
You're gonna become the magician, okay? I'll help you though, I'll start. See how the needle looks? Like, see how it looks like
yeah.
It's going into the arm? See that?
Yeah.
See how it really looks.
Is this selfish that I think that if that goes through your arm, it might hurt me as well? There might be collateral damage. Oh, that's...
See how it really looks?
Yeah. Yeah, it does.
Like the needle. It's actually going.
What the f***? Seriously? This is mental. What? That's mental.
See how it really looks?
Sorry, David, seriously. This isn't a trick. You're just sticking a needle through your arm. What are you doing?
See how it looks?
That's horrible.
How it looks, Ricky. Like it's really
good. You're a maniac.
See how it looks like.
That's the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. What are you doing?
See how really believable
looks. Oh, God. I'm not good with this. That's crazy.
You see that?
How the f*** are you... Wait, what do you mean, how are you doing it? You've stuck a needle through your f***ing arm.
It looks pretty real, right?
Sorry, I don't understand. How is that not real? What do you mean it looks pretty real?
It's the same as what I just did to you.
What? This is all glue?
Well, it looks really real, right?
I don't understand. Right, okay. Obviously, if that is a trick, how is that a trick? How is that not a needle going through your arm?
You know what, Ricky, here, do me a favor. Grab the needle right here.
Yeah?
And pull it out so you could see the magic trick. Go ahead, grab it. Yeah, good.
What do you mean?
Yeah, grab
pull it out sure. All the way it's come.
Yeah, pull it out. Good. Just pull it right out.
Right, okay.
Pull it out.
Is that needle going through your arm?
Well, pull it out and you'll see how it works. Pull it.
Oh, me! I don't understand.
Good, pull. Pull.
Oh, David, what have you done? Are you a maniac?
Pull.
This is real. Sorry, this is real. That's real. That's not a trick. Oh, for sake. How? I don't... That's not... That's real. There's no... That's... He stuck a needle through his arm. You saw it. You saw it, right? He stuck a needle through his arm. But he couldn't have, because no one would do that. So how did he do it? Why would you? Why would you do that? What, now he's just gone? Just gone for lunch? This was something else. I mean, it was amazing. Either way, it's amazing. One is that it's one of the best illusions I've ever seen close up. Or you're a maniac. Either way, well done. well done. That it, I'm still on my first theory here. That it did happen, and that's not a trick. It's a double bluff. So you just did something, and you want people to think it's an amazing illusion, like your card tricks, but actually you just stuck things to your arm. That's brilliant. If that's true, it's brilliant. It's the best con ever, because it's not a con. It's like someone pretending to cut their foot off, and then they hobble off without a foot. And they go, do you see that? It looked like I cut my foot off. Where's your foot? Doesn't matter.